Welcome to another episode. In this episode, we'll answer a question: the start destroy our life. The full question is lengthy, which I will read. But in short, it is whether the thought will destroy our life. Whatever is running inside our mind 24 hours for a particular person is our problem. That is first part of the question. Is that going to affect or destroy the life of the person in reality for which those thoughts are running? This is the second part of the question. In the second part of the question, what he wants to ask is, for the person who thought arises, will that person be destroyed by that? Life of that person will be destroyed by that thoughts. So these are the two parts of the question. In short, you can say whether thoughts destroy your life. Your thoughts destroy your life. You'll answer that. It is normal for everyone. Our thoughts, as Buddha said, it is like a drunken monkey. It is jumping from one place to another. Yes, it definitely affects our life. Our life is always in conflict, in violence, which is either physical or mental, in pain and no peace. Yes, it does destroy our normal living. We have all given thought undue importance. We have been trained that way, to give thought so much of importance in our life, instead of using thought as a tool. In our life, we have made it our master. Instead of making it as a servant, we have made it as a master. We identify ourselves with thought. So what is the solution? Give thought its place, its due place, as a tool, as a planning tool, as a way of conveying. That is what thought is meant for. And just don't identify thoughts. Understand your consciousness beyond the thought. You are not just thought. So first, to corroborate this, our answer, we will take up what the enlightened people have said about thought. First is, who am I? The teachings of Ramana Bhagavan, Sri Ramana Maharishi. So from that book, I'll take a few quotes. How will the mind become quiescent, quiet? By inquiry, who am I? The thought, who am I, will destroy all other thoughts. And like the stick used to stirring the burning fire, it will itself in the end get destroyed. Then there will arise self-realization. What is the means for constantly holding on to the thought, who am I? When other thoughts arise, one should not pursue them, but should inquire, to whom do they arise? It does not matter how many thoughts arise. As each thought arises, one should inquire with diligence, to whom has this thought arisen? The answer that would emerge would be, to me. Thereupon, if one inquires, who am I? The mind will go back to its source, and the thought that arose will become quiet. So what he means is, as soon as the thought arises, you question yourself, to whom this thought arises? You're not the thought. The thought arises from where? It is the consciousness beyond the thought. There the thought arises. So this question will go back to the source which is consciousness, universal consciousness. There is no particular person, it is not the body, it is not the mind, it is not the thought. It arises to the person beyond the thought. Thought arises from there. So it is not a repetition, japa or meditation, but understanding. There is a true meditation, understanding beyond this question. What is beyond this question? So next we will take up Ultimate Alchemy Volume 1 Osho. From that we will see a quote. Mind has many types of thoughts. Every thought is wavering. every thought is a wave. If there are no thoughts, then the mind will be non-wavering. A single thought and you have trembled. A single thought and you are not still. And a single thought is not a single thought. It is a very complex phenomena. A single thought is created by many waves. Even a single word is created by many waves. So only when there are many waves in the mind is a single word created. And a single thought has many words. Thousands and thousands of ripples create one thought. Thought is the outermost, but the waves have preceded. You become aware only when waves become thoughts, because your awareness is grass. You cannot be aware when the waves are pure waves, still in the formation of becoming a thought. The more you will become aware, the more you will feel that thought has many layers. The thought form is the last. Before thought, there are seed waves, which create the thought, and therefore seed waves, there are still deeper roots, which create seeds. Seeds create thought. At least three layers are very easily visible for a conscious mind. But we are not conscious. We are asleep. So we become aware only when waves take the grossest form of thought. So what Osho says is, a single thought, a light thought arises, but it is not just thought, the seeds are there. It is a waveform. From the silent consciousness, the seeds of thought arise, it creates a wave. That wave is called the thought which comes out. There is a background behind it. So we will have to clear everything for the mind to become still. That's what Osho says. Next, we will see the work of Byron Katie, an introduction. This is by Byron Katie. Instead of hopelessly trying to change the world to match our thoughts about how it should be, we can question these thoughts and, by meeting reality as it is, experience unimaginable freedom and joy. A thought is harmless unless we believe it. It is not our thoughts, but the attachment to our thought that causes suffering. Attaching to a thought means believing that it is true, without inquiry. A belief is a thought that we have been attaching to, often for years. Thoughts just appear. They come out of nothing and go back to nothing. Like clouds moving across the empty sky, they come to pass, not to stay. There is no harm in them until we attach to them as if they were true. I don't let go of my thoughts. I meet them with the understanding. Then they let go of me. So in short, thought in itself is harmless. It comes and goes. Unless you hold on to it, you give value to it. Otherwise, like an empty cloud, it comes and passes and goes away. From nothing it comes and it goes back to nothing. We attach to it. We give importance to it. That is the problem. Let the thoughts come and go. It will come. It will go. Don't give importance to it. Then we will see a quote from Srimad Bhagavad Gita. The thoughts of the irresolute are many branches, truly endless. The thoughts of the irresolute are many branches, truly endless. Acting with the body alone, without wish, thought and self-restraint, abandoning all thoughts of gain. Though acting, he incurs no fault. Abandoning all thoughts of gain, though acting, he incurs no fault. Released from desire and anger, with thoughts restrained, those ascetics who know the self find very near the bliss of Brahma Nirvana. Released from desire and anger, with thoughts restrained, those ascetics who know the self find very near the bliss of Brahma Nirvana. Next we will see Dattatreya, song of the Avadhoot. But say the mystics, this superficial play of thoughts, memories, sense impressions upon the screen of awareness is but a mirage. It is the screen, awareness itself, that is our true identity. The thoughts are like the movie which is played on the screen, which has no value. What is real is the screen, which is the awareness or consciousness, that is true. Next we will see from the essence of Rebekita. What is this mind except a bundle of thoughts? What are the thoughts except evanescent ripples in the still, limitless ocean of pure being, awareness self, which is a sole existence without a second, unbroken abidance in the state of alert awareness, unruffled by thought, is the self-realization. So the thoughts of our evanescent ripples in the still, limitless ocean of pure being, awareness. They are just ripples. Next we will see joyous studies, joyous teachings of Baal Shem Tov. Study with energy and great joy, that will reduce disturbing thoughts. This is Zava at Harivash 51. The life of Hasidism, the thoughts whose real intent is not what is thought but themselves. Their brilliance are shadows. So thoughts are an end in itself, not the object which is thought itself. Thought has an end in itself. It takes pleasure in itself. More and more thoughts. That is the pleasure, not the action. So beware of it. So with this we will end this episode. Thank you for staying with me. Subscribe to my channel.